how was your weekend? I know I wasn't here yesterday. That was because of jury duty, which took place virtually. So I was kind of waiting by my phone. And, yeah. Well, it's over. I'm good for 3 years, so let's get right down to it, shall we? We're coming with the Raven's Prophecy deck today. This is the one that you'll never see me do reversals with this deck because it's not built with those in mind. And it was never their intention for these cards to be read in reverse. So I won't be doing any reversals today. It will be all upright and ready to go, just like I always do. But I'm going to attempt more reversals. Not necessarily from... not from the Oracle cards, but definitely from the Tarot. Because I kind of feel like it's not all negativity. Because if you get a double card in reverse, that's liberation. If you get it upright, it's, you know, you're stuck. You're hopelessly chained to something. See, Three of Swords, for example. Three of Swords, that one, that's a real-world example that came up one of the readings last week. And that is a heartbreak card. And whenever that card comes up, that's something that's really just killing you. But if it's in reverse, well, it means just the opposite. It means something that is that can now bring you joy. Get what I'm saying? I hope so. It's kind of early in the... It's a little early in the morning. I'm going to try to get in and get this done so I can leave. Get to work at a decent time. Try to get this... I've already got the editor opened. I made sure I prepared everything, so... Anyway, start with you this morning. Two of Wands. So... this one's a little iffy today. I really need to see a lot more context. And I'll tell you why. Because this particular card, its image, it reminds me of another card. That card being in the Tarot of the Divine, which tells the story of the rainbow-colored raven who decided to bring fire to the world so that we wouldn't freeze. And so he swooped into a fire, snatched a couple of wands out, scorched his wings black in the process. The smoke choked out his rather beautiful singing voice, but it's his sacrifice that's remembered. I do see that sacrifice here today, but I see a sacrifice inside of a partnership. Funny enough, on Twitter this weekend, I've seen a lot of posts about relationships, how relationships won't make you happy, and that's true. Really, what it'll do is it'll make you miserable with someone. Get me so far? So really, those posts are about you working on yourself. And that's something I've been hammering home since this whole thing began. Let's go to the top row here, your mind. We got a Seven of Cups. Got a Chariot. And we have the Sun. Seven of Cups. Now, this is that choice that you have to make. It's a deep mental choice. You know which choices are going to be good for you, which will be great in the long term, which will be satisfying in the short term but not so good, and some that are downright toxic. So, starting from there, you move through the Chariot, which is forward movement. This is where you become unstoppable. This is that forward momentum that you need. But you have to make the choice first. And if you make the right choice, your entire path is eliminated before you. This is your potential outcome here. Really, the Seven of Cups and the Sun can be one and the same. Your present situation, you know exactly what you need to do. So just get in that chariot and start moving. Start moving in the right direction. For the body, or the physical, we have the High Priestess, the Hierophant, and the Fool. A lot of court cards today. A lot of them. And the High Priestess tells you that it's okay to do your own thing. It's okay not to go rules as written. It's okay to engage in a little free form every once in a while. But the Hierophant reminds you that there are guidelines in place and they're there for a reason. So always be considerate of that. And that comes before taking that new adventure. So, what I'm seeing here is the decision to take on this new adventure is totally yours. And it's a good thing. It can be very healthy. But you also have to remember to set those limits for yourself. I usually say unlimit yourself. I like you without limits. I like you taking your personal power and just unleashing it upon the world. I love seeing all of you do amazing things. Whether it's writing a book, whether it's coming up with a new tarot deck, any of that. I don't care what it is that lights you up from the inside. I usually say do it, just, you know, shine like hell, because, hey, even if I can't handle that light, you should not have to put it away because I just need to pop on a pair of sunglasses. My reaction to it is not your responsibility. However, you are going to need support. You cannot be naive in your thinking right now. Kind of understand what I'm saying? Is you're striking a balance between the High Priestess, which is do your own thing, and this Hierophant, which is sort of an appeal to authority. In order for you to take that new journey, in order for you to take that new adventure, in order for you to go on that well-lit path, you really have to understand why there's a path there, at least for now. Sometimes going off the beaten track is a great thing. You notice things that other people won't, but sometimes that beaten track is there for a reason. Just keep that in mind. Finally, in the spirit, we have the Ace of Swords. We have a King of Swords, and we have the Moon. Sun and the Moon in the same reading. That's kind of wild. See, the Ace of Swords is very much clarity of thought. And you really do need to clear your mind. You know, step away from all the noise for a minute. Sometimes that's needed. I hope you did that this weekend. Because the King of Swords is very, very secure in their thoughts. With this popping up in the spiritual, you have to be very secure and have a clear head, because you're navigating through some very dark territory, so you're going from this clear thought into a mature version of it, because you have to navigate some fairly dark territory here. You're always kind of reaching for that light. You always have to remember that not every situation can be attacked from, you know, the same way. This is that card that kind of tells me when all you have is a hammer, every problem looks like a nail. Yeah, it's definitely not all nails. And then finally, This is about perspective. See, the raven isn't swallowing the moon. The raven's calling to it. Raven's observing it. But to us, from our perspective, it looks like, oh my goodness, he's swallowing the moon. What will we do without that little bit of light? Well, that's not something you have to worry about. Because going back to the Two of Wands and the Seven of Cups, it's all about choices. And you have to make the right one. You have to make that decision, and you have to make it for yourself. Some decisions are very easy, others, not so much. I can't tell you what decisions to make. All I can tell you is that when the time comes today, you will know exactly which decision is right and which one will absolutely jack you up. Play the long game today, because that's exactly what you're being told to do. Balance that need to just go your own way versus doing things as written. Because sometimes rules as written has a very, very good reason for being there. It has been thought over. Kind of go a little rules as interpreted. There's that proper balance. I know it didn't take long, and I wish I had a little more time to hang out with you. I do, because I love you. All I want you to do is take care of yourselves and each other. Always do what lights you up. At every opportunity. And as always, my friends, like the sun, shine on.